When I woke up on 9/11, I do what I do very often during the week. I went to the gym and watching TV, standing with others, looking at this screen, I thought I was watching something that was surreal. Immediately ran to the synagogue here. When I arrived here, the inspector of the 84th precinct said to me, "Rabbi, I want you here. Let's establish a triage center because people are going to be running over the bridge." We opened all the doors, we put chairs out, we got water, we arranged for cars to take people home because there was no public transportation that day. We saw to it that a house of worship represented safe and sacred space for everyone. And then a few hours later, I went over the bridge because I felt an obligation to be there. And I'll never forget arriving there and seeing buildings that had collapsed, knowing there was human devastation here. There were body parts, there were bodies, there were people searching for loved ones they thought were still alive. We had to do something to help those who were hurting so deeply. What I did was I presented myself to the command center, to those who were in charge, and said, "Look, I'm available, I'm a chaplain, whatever you need me to do." What we did was we prayed, we gave spiritual and moral support to firefighters, to all first responders. When bodies were found, we prayed over them. I remember it wasn't that far away from Rosh Hashanah. I recall sounding the shofar at Ground Zero and being surrounded by many non-Jews who said, "This is a spiritual moment for all of us." So that day and every day that I was there, I tried to do whatever I could, but I've never seen so many people who tried to do so much. And I will always admire people of all different faith traditions who once again, like firefighters, did not ask, "What's the religion of this person?" This is a human being, member of the human family, and we have to help as much as we can. When you walk into the sanctuary here, one of the first things you see is a helmet that has the number 343. That number represents the number of firefighters who lost their lives on 9/11. It is above a Torah that was hidden during the Holocaust. So we felt that the Holocaust reminds us of a horrific period, but still people who were able to triumph over evil. 9/11 is also the story of triumph over evil. As I reflect on the 10th anniversary, I ask the question, what have you learned from all of this? And I think the answer I would give is, we have the ability, as difficult as it is, to begin again.